Hey guys, Joseph Fulmer here. Today I'm going to show you the proper way to check when you're checking for power and ground on a component to see if you have adequate power or an adequate ground source to that component. Because most of you are familiar with 12 volt test lights like this one. As you can see, this is an LED test light. It's a good test light, nothing wrong with it. It'll tell you whether you have a power source or a ground source depending on how you hook it up. If you're looking for a ground, you hook it up to your battery positive, and then when you find a ground, the light lights up. Works great. The only problem is, if you already know you have power and ground, that you do have power or you do have a ground, but for some reason that component is still not functioning, it may be that you're not able to get enough amperage through the wire. So, in that case, the proper way to test it is with a 12 volt incandescent light bulb, which I have here. Now this one is just a tail light brake light bulb that I pulled two of the wires loose, soldered on, as you can kind of see, soldered on some extensions, and then I just put some solder on the ends down here. That way I can hook alligator clips to them if I need to. Now today I'm working on the computer, trying to figure out why this thing isn't starting, and I think it's an issue with powers and grounds at the computer. Here's the deal. This pulls several amps. As a matter of fact, I can tell you right now, we'll swap this over. And this bulb pulls almost 2 amps. Okay? It takes 2 amps to light that light bulb. To light this test light, takes 0.02 amps. So you can see there's a major difference in power draw here. If you don't have a wire, if you have a wire that is compromised where maybe it's broken and there's only a couple strands still left, it'll carry less than 1 amp without any trouble. Carrying more than 1 amp is going to require a decent piece, you know, you're going to have some decent wire. So you want to make sure when you're checking for powers and grounds that your light bulb, as you can see here, hopefully you guys can see this, it's lighting up nice and bright. I mean, I don't know if you can tell from the camera, but it's almost blinding over here. And I'm going through, I have it hooked to the battery on one end, and since I'm checking grounds, I'm on the battery positive, and I'm touching it to what should be the ground pins in my connector. And then to check for power, I just switch the light over to my battery negative, and I've got a battery charger on here so that I don't run the battery dead while I'm running these tests, so it makes it real easy just to use the clip from the battery charger to pin down the end of the wire here, although I can't see now. Problem is, now I'm seeing spots from that light coming on, but I got the end of the wire pinned down, and now I can check my power, which I know you guys may not be able to see this real well, but now I have power there, and my other one here is an ignition. Yeah, it's not on because the key isn't turned off. So, that is the proper way to check to make sure you have a good power and a good ground. And this was just an old used light bulb that I pulled out of a vehicle. A couple cents worth of wire. You can make them longer if you needed to. But that is that, guys. It's the proper way to check for power and ground on a circuit. Alright? So, do me a favor. If you like the video, if it helps you at all, give me a thumbs up. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. And guys, don't be afraid to get out there and get your hands dirty. You might just have fun doing it.